对美国的总统 Joe Biden 来说，有一个坏消息正在发生。我们常常说，你如果政治形象越好，你发生任何丑闻，对你的杀伤力就更大。川普的家族过去，人们会说他的女儿或是他的女婿库什长有哪些问题，川普的家族怎么样逃税，他如何诈欺税务等等，似乎对他的声望影响不大。为什么？因为美国很少人是因为诚实而支持川普，他支持川普是别的理由。Joe Biden 不一样，他让很多人觉得他是一个好人，他算是一个正常的政客，或者他是一个诚实的爱家的好男人。但最近关于他儿子 Hunter Biden 的新闻越卷越大，很可能对 Biden 跟对美国的政局都造成很大的影响。那么 Biden 作为一个美国的总统，其实很难施压美国的司法部门，这不太是美国的司法部门是可以容许的。那 Biden 也不太可能跟川普时代一样，他就换司法部长说你不准调查 Hunter Biden。 那某个程度 Biden 的确陷入他可能的下一场政治风暴，因为他的儿子。
Do you regret being on the board to begin with?
No, I don't regret being on the board. What I regret is not taking into account that there would be a Rudy Giuliani and a president of the United States that would be listening to this ridiculous conspiracy idea.
有越来越多证据证明亨特口中的阴谋论不全是杜撰的故事。最新进展是《纽约时报》说，亨特·拜登让他的好朋友一名好莱坞律师替他支付了超过$200万的贷款和生活费。然而，这段友谊已令白宫感到忧心。这位凯文·莫里斯是谁呢？莫里斯的娱乐法律公司曾接受包括史嘉蕾·乔韩森、艾伦·迪珍妮和马修·麦康奈等人委托。他除了替名人打官司，还身兼小说家和制作人。他挂名制作的音乐剧还得过美国东尼奖。《纽约时报》说，莫里斯在先前亨特抚养费诉讼时为他提供法律意见，甚至在2021年4月初的亨特回忆录都是在他协助下完成。《纽约时报》说，莫里斯正着手拍摄一部亨特纪录片，要把亨特描绘成前总统川普及其盟友的政治受害者。然而，这些尝试与亨特律师团策略相抵触。他们主张，在亨特仍在接受联邦调查期间，应该谨慎行事。白宫拒绝评论。
Well, again, the president doesn't have dealings with his family members about business, and he has released decades of tax returns.
GOP Congressman James Comer said that Hunter is a, quote, national security risk, and added it will be a top priority to find out if the president was involved in Hunter's business deals if Republicans take back the House.
Did you and your father ever discuss Ukraine?
No. As I said, the only time was after a news account, and it wasn't a discussion in any way. There's no but to this, no.
针对亨特·拜登的税务调查，始于他父亲仍在奥巴马政府担任副总统时，调查之后扩大到包括潜在的税务诈欺、洗钱和违反游说法。
It began as an examination of whether he paid all the taxes he should have on income from his work for foreign companies, including Burisma Holdings, a Ukrainian energy company. This email from a former business partner, for example, found on a laptop computer Biden used, said he failed to disclose $400,000 that he was paid by the Ukrainian company.
这么机密的电邮怎会外泄呢？
That laptop, which he took to a Delaware shop to get repaired but never reclaimed, was seized by the FBI, but not before Trump lawyer Rudy Giuliani got a copy of its hard drive, which he shared with congressional Republicans. Documents they've made public show that accounts linked to Biden also received nearly $4 million in consulting contracts from a Chinese energy company, according to an analysis by the Washington Post. But during the campaign, then-candidate Biden denied there was a China connection.
My son has not made money in terms of this thing about, what are you talking about, China.
Senate Republicans say the documents also show Hunter Biden signed an agreement to represent an official of that company, Patrick Ho, for $1 million. Ho was later convicted in a U.S. court of trying to bribe government officials in Africa.
Hunter. He goes in, he has a meeting, he walks out. It is fund with...$1.5 billion, with a B, $1.5 billion!
先前提及亨特好友莫里斯正在着手拍摄的纪录片，就是要为亨特洗刷冤屈。即使包括《纽约时报》的媒体在内，已经证实了部分文件的真实性，莫里斯仍质疑这些文件是否全部来自被遗弃的笔电。说到这台引发风暴的笔电，当初接下维修工作的老板现在也出书洗刷他因为这起事件所蒙受的冤屈。
Well, on October 14th, when the New York Post ran the story, my information was leaked, and pretty much right out of the gate, I was labeled a hacker and then an agent of Putin or a part of a Russian disinformation campaign.I first went after Twitter because if I ever wanted to rebuild my computer business, having the label of hacker over my head is just, that's never going to happen. It's a death sentence in my industry. So we went after Twitter and I got destroyed by Twitter. The judge was replaced with an Obama-appointed judge. The case was thrown out and I was punished by the Florida slap legislation by Twitter. So I never thought I'd have the opportunity to seekaccountability for those who slandered me. And until the America Project stepped up about a month ago and offered to step in and sponsor my lawsuit. So I had wanted to go after Adam Schiff for a while. He was quite quick to go on CNN and tell their viewers that this was all coming out of the Kremlin and I was part of a Russian disinformation campaign. And the notion of me,contributing or working with a foreign power to interfere with a national election, I mean, that's being labeled a traitor, and I can't have that, and I won't stand for that.
在这本书里，他写到了改变他命运的那一晚，就是2019年4月一个星期五的晚上，还有十分钟就要打烊了，一名男子跌跌撞撞走进来，手上拿了三台 MacBook 笔电。他说，我很高兴你还开着，从雪茄吧来的，他们说你七点打烊，叫我动作快点。男子说笔电进水无法开机要送修，一拿到笔电他就注意到苹果 logo 贴了拜登基金会贴纸，我问他名字，他回答亨特，我再问他姓什么，他顿了一下，有点惊讶地看了我一眼，好像我是个外国人，怎么可能有人不认识他，但他还是回了我，我姓拜登。恢复数据时，一张张不雅照、亨特的自拍色情影片都跳了出来，接着就是一封封涉及各种金钱往来的邮件，部分内容在这几年已陆续曝光。关键问题是，亨特这些事，拜登知道吗？
Could any of this information in any way implicate President Biden?
White House Chief of Staff was asked about this issue, and he said that the president felt that his family had done the right thing.But then also added that these were the actions of Hunter Biden and James Biden, the president's brother, and that these were private matters, and that President Biden was not involved.
现阶段拜登支持率低迷不振， CNN 预测其中选举国会极有可能变天，共和党已经表明在重掌众议院后必定会在国会传唤亨特回答问题。